All of your questions about Beaver Themer are about to be answered. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies, and I make and upload these videos to YouTube every single day. So if you enjoy the content in this video, I would like you to maybe consider subscribing. Now, if you are not aware, there's a new product about to be released called Beaver Themer, and it is made by the folks that make Beaver Builder, and it's kind of a companion plugin that is going to work side by side with Beaver Builder to really unlock some superpowers on your website. And I know that this is going to be, in my mind, probably the most powerful tool in anyone's toolbox that has a website or is building websites for people once you understand what it does. And that's probably kind of the problem. There's a lot of people know what it does, but not everybody knows what it does. So I thought to myself, this is going to be released in about 1 or 2 weeks. I'm going to do a daily video series on Beaver Themer and try to get all of the things that it's going to do to make your life better, easier, give you more time, make things easier. And I'm going to release a video each day on it so that when the product does launch in 1 or 2 weeks, that you will know if it's a good fit for you. And that is the same with any product. You've got to figure out if it's a good fit for you. And I'm going to tell you, with Beaver Themer, it's not a good fit for everybody. It's not perfect for everybody. There are scenarios where it's going to be the most amazing thing you've ever experienced, but there's going to be plenty of situations where you probably don't need it. Now, let's go over to their website, Beaver Builder's website. And right now on their blog, there's 2 posts about it. There was a post about a week or so ago announcing the cost. It's going to cost $147, I believe, and there's going to be a discount for the first couple days or so for their existing customers to be able to purchase this Beaver Themer. But if you're a customer, you've already had access to it for the last 3 months or so, or since February. I've been using it since February and am completely blown away at what it does. So let me just try to give you some of the basics of how this video series is going to work. I need your help. I need you to get out from behind the internet shadows, leave a comment down below on what you want to know how to do with Beaver Themer so that I have enough material to make it till this launches. If the launch is in 2 weeks, that means that's 14 videos I need to make. Now, I will say, the day before it launches, I'm going to post a video that I'm going to do an interview with Robbie from Beaver Builder. And in this interview, we are going to answer your frequently asked questions, and we're going to talk about Beaver Themer. It's not going to be one of those interviews where he tells me how Beaver Builder got started. You can listen to any of the 50 different podcasts that he's been on if you want that information. This is going to be information specific to Beaver Themer and everything about it. Now, in a nutshell, Beaver Themer is going to make it so that you can use Beaver Builder to design pretty much any area of your website. So right now with Beaver Builder, you can design pages and posts. And with posts, it's not even the most efficient way of doing it, because if you want to change your post format, you would have to manually do that for each post that you used Beaver Builder on. So it's not the most efficient way. And that is the introduction of Beaver Themer, where you can create templates for your post. Let me show you an idea right now of what a post template looks like. If you're on my website, this is my standard post template. If you've ever been to my site and clicked on any of the blog content videos or whatever here, this is what it looks like. And this is a template. They all look like this, where we have a video, we have my title here, we have these different colored backgrounds, we have these other thumbnails here, and then my content. This is how they all look, and it's a global thing. Now, traditionally, it is very difficult to change that. You have to modify code, and it's just not something that 90% of us are going to want to do or be able to do. Let me give you some perspective on that. If you head over to the Elegant Themes blog, and Elegant Themes, they make Divi. Divi's a great page builder, and they're going one direction, Beaver Builder's going a different direction. Now, they just started a new blog post series. It's going to be 3 blog posts on how to do kind of what Beaver Themer allows you to do, which is make different styles of your blog post templates. Okay, this is just one little thing that Beaver Themer does, by the way. And it's a 3-part blog series, and I'm not dissing Divi at all. It's just... it's an apples to oranges comparison at this point, but I just want to give you some perspective of what Beaver Themer does, and it's the only thing that can do this, okay? You go to Elegant Themes blog here, and you scroll down, and you're like, huh, okay, I might want my blog post to look like this. And you scroll down, and there are, like, all these snippets of code you have to put in all these different places. So let me show you. So here we go. Now we're getting into the nitty-gritty of code that needs to go into FTP and all these different PHP files and all this kind of stuff. And that was just the first post. Here's the second one. And it's just more of the same. All these complicated bits of code that you have to put in to just modify what your post template would look like. So right here, I just showed you my blog post template. If I wanted to change that, it's going to be a problem. So I've been using Beaver Themer on my website, and I decided to test this new blog post template right here. And I made my video larger. I put the thumbnail image in the background. I put this little overlay color in, and this was all using Beaver Themer. I did not touch one line of code. I didn't have to copy and paste any code anywhere. It's all using Beaver Builder, which, I mean, if you just got Beaver Builder, it only takes about 5-10 minutes to fully understand how to use this stinking thing. And I changed where my title location is and how my content gets laid out. And I even did this really cool custom thing here where my transcriptions will go in this box that kind of just blends into the background. And I put this author info here. I mean, I was able to do this in about 10 minutes, and I can assign this globally to whatever bits of content that I want. This is what I was able to do with Beaver Themer in just a few minutes. To do that with Elegant Theme, you got to go here and copy and paste all kinds of complicated bits of code, and you still don't get it the way you want it. You get it to look like this. This might not be how you want it to look, but that's just what you have to live with. So you can't even really get it to be how you want. You can get it to be different, but with Beaver Themer, you can have full control over the layout of a blog post. That is one tiny little sliver of what you can do with Beaver Themer. Where I think the holy grail is with Beaver Themer is the ability to customize Woo theme product pages. I think that is the money feature right there. I've always felt that the Woo themes product pages are really kind of dull and boring, and I've never really liked them. And now, with Beaver Themer, you're going to be able to totally change the way these product pages look. So now I've probably talked about 20% of what Beaver Themer is going to allow you to do. If you go to Beaver Builder's website and read these 2 blog posts, you're going to see all these new things that it allows you to do. So that's why I want to do this video series. Each day, have a video to show you the power and exactly how to use it. So when it is available for purchase, you're going to know, number one, if it's for you, and number two, you're already going to know how to use it. That's my goal of this video series. And it does more things, of course, if you have the Beaver Builder theme, and I think maybe 1 or 2 other themes. You're going to be able to use Beaver Themer to totally create custom headers and footers. And you can even have full control over which pages they appear on. So say you have a dynamic website where maybe you have a membership area. You can have a totally different header in the members area than you do for everybody else on your website. This is powerful stuff, guys. So powerful. You're going to have full control over who sees what and when they see it. And they also have another new feature called, they're calling it theme parts. It's kind of hard to wrap your mind around it. So this is different areas of your website where you can create some content in Beaver Builder and just toss it right in there, slip it right in there. So a real easy to understand example is when you go to, say, someone's blog, you read the blog post, and at the bottom, there's an area there on every blog post or whatever that says, hey, do you want to subscribe? And there's a button or something like that. That's kind of like a theme part where you can create these now in Beaver Builder, and you can put them in all these different locations on your website. There's actually a ton of great marketing use case scenarios of this. You can say have maybe a banner ad or a banner announcement above WooCommerce product pages, or maybe different blog posts that have an opt-in. There's so many different powerful uses for this theme parts and all the different locations where you can put it. You can have a theme part be right above the footer of your theme, right below the header, all these different locations. I really think it's going to be a power feature. Now, I think we're, in my mind, some of the most powerful features are for a developer are with something called custom post types. So if you use a plugin that creates a custom post type like a WooCommerce product page, or if you have a learning management system and there might be a lesson designed layout page, you can totally change and override the looks of those pages and how things are laid out. But where there's real power is in creating custom post types. And what that is, you know, WordPress isn't sometimes a one size fits all. It's more of a one size fits most. There are scenarios where the content you want to put on your website doesn't necessarily fit in the context of a page or a post. A couple examples of that would be maybe you have a website that needs to have events. Well, you would want events in their own separate category, and you'd want their pages to look totally different. That would be a custom post type, and then you can use Beaver Builder to design that layout. Another example is say you had a staff directory, say you're a company and you need a staff directory. Well, that would be a custom post type for each staff member. Actually, when I was on this blog post and I was down here looking at the comments section of all these people that have been using Beaver Themer, someone posted a link to a website they made. I hope you don't mind if you watch this video. I hope you don't mind me referencing this, but I thought this was a perfect example of a custom post type, how WordPress is a one size fits most, and Beaver Themer really unlocking the true potential. So this developer built this beautiful website, and they created a custom post type for the pets that are available for adoption. So he created it. Here you can click on adoptable, and you can see this. So obviously each of these pets available for adoption, it doesn't really fit in the context of a blog post, and it doesn't really fit in the context of a page. So you create a custom post type. And then when you click on one of these adorable pets, you can see there is a custom layout just for that bit of content. So you can see right here your name, your age, the sex, the breed, the image, and a little bit about the dog. And this is just so cute. This was done by creating a custom post type and then using Beaver Themer to make it actually look beautiful on the front end. If you have a website where you're going to list a bunch of books, that could be a custom post type. So there's so many use case scenarios for custom post types. In this video series, we're going to have a video dedicated to that. That's going to be one of the later videos on the best tools to create these custom post types and then using Beaver Themer to show it on the front end. So I hope you can see the massive potential of Beaver Themer. I want you to be a part of this video series. I want you to guide and direct this video series. And the only way we can do that together is if you take a minute, go to the comment section down below and tell me what you want to learn, or ask me any question that you want me to ask Robbie when I have that interview. I want to open this up to you to guide this video series. We're going to go along your path of what you want to learn in this video series. We're going to touch it all, and I'm not going to be able to do that if you don't hop in and join in and let me know what you want to know, and let me know what you want me to ask Robbie in a few days. So the best next step for you would be to consider clicking on the subscribe button, and then right off to the right of that, there's a little cute bell. When you click on that, it's going to turn on YouTube notifications for my channel. That means when I upload a new video, YouTube's going to just send you a message saying, hey, Adam just uploaded the next video in this Beaver Themer countdown video series. And then you'll know that the content is there ready, waiting for you. And then after you do that, let me know what you want to learn about Beaver Themer down below.